Hello. Good morning, everybody. Yes, Thursday's update. I'm here. I'm happy to be back in the States. I love America. I love the United States. I love the economy here. I love the system here. I love Europe for vacation. That's beautiful. I have a lot of friends, almost family in Europe, in Spain, Italy. But let me tell you, this is the real deal right here, America. Love it. So I'm gonna be talking a little bit about that, about my trip. You know, I was in Italy and Spain last week. I've been back and working full motion this week. I have one day off with my kids. I took them to Disney. I'm blessed and happy for that. I love my kids. I'm gonna be talking about something that I'm doing right now, just in case you don't know, you're not familiar. Relentless. Jose, brother, what happened? I didn't see you this morning working out, brother. And I didn't see you yesterday with Mikey Garcia. We didn't take the photo, man. Well, I did, you didn't. I hope you're doing great. I'll see you in a bit. I'm gonna be talking about that, relentless today. And I have a little message to my kids, as usual. And something that I'm learning right now that I love to share with you guys. So, back to normal first. As you know, I was on vacation. Hey, Harry, how you doing? And the experience of going to Europe, going to Italy, going to Spain, meeting my all-time friend, forever friends. I don't know if you know, I'm originally from Venezuela. 18 years ago, I was blessed. I had the opportunity to leave Venezuela to move to the States. I went to Cal State Northridge, learned English. And being here, I meet this office and company that help you move to the state and get a visa to work if you find a sponsor, which I did. I'm only the few people I know from Venezuela who have done it. And I was happy to do it. I was looking always forward to move to the States. This is just the lifestyle I like and the lifestyle I was looking for. Anyhow, I move from here, and when I move from here, I don't know if you know, Venezuela is going through a crisis. Communism, narco government, and a lot of things. It's just a crisis. It's sad. It's right now probably the poorest country in the world. And I still have family and friends there, but that's not the conversation I'm having right now. The conversation is, when I moved to the States, a lot of my friends and family moved to Europe, Spain, Italy. And we always been in touch, and I had the opportunity to go and see them. And the two or three different things I want to talk about Europe particularly, yes, it's a great place for tourism, vacation. It's beautiful. People is amazing. The food, extraordinary. I gained 10 pounds. I'm already down 2 pounds. And well, yes, you should go there and visit. But what I noticed, most of the people I know in the conversation everybody was having is how hard the times are over there. The income, the money is not enough. Everything is more expensive than here. Hey, Diane, how you doing? Long time to see you. And yes, I don't know if you know, in Europe, the minimum wage, is, I think it's 6, 7, 8 euros an hour. I'm just saying the minimum wage just to give you a relationship. Doesn't mean that's the way it is all the time. But when I do this, it's to give you a perspective. In America, I don't know if you know, the minimum wage, hey Juan, Elena, is depending on the state, but here in California it's $10.50, the minimum, but most of the people make more than that, like $12 an hour. And most of the time you can get overtime. And especially if you work on the service industry, like waitress, bartender, valet parking. On top of that, you get the tips. Here in America, the culture is about giving. And I believe that is the secret of success in America. The biggest, or not the biggest, the strongest economy right now. We are the second or the third largest economy in the world after China and India. And one of the blessings we have in America, we always giving. And that part, when you go out for lunch to a restaurant, and you give the tip 10, 15, 20%, or you do a valet parking and you tip the guy helping you with the valet, or you're getting a drink at the bar, a soda, and you tip the guy at the bar, that's money that you're giving, not only for the service you're getting, it's because there is a secret on that. And Tony Robbins talks about this, the secret of living is giving. So every time you give, you're gonna receive more. It's just the energy, it's just the frequency. And this universe is, I believe that's one of the blessings of America. All the time we're giving, all the time we're doing a foundation, a charity, or we're gonna do a seminar to give more information. Like me right now, this little time I have on Thursdays, I share with you some information that might be valuable for you. I'm giving you my time, I'm giving you my information, I'm giving you my experience. Maybe I know my be Tony Robbins or Danny Morebe, I'm me, and I'm here with you. And I care about this, and I really appreciate every time you see the video, or you comment, or you share, or you like my post. I really appreciate it when I see people that I'm not very familiar with, and they give me compliments of the videos. Like I'm right now at the Relentless event, I'm on training. Yes, training, because if you're having vacation, and you're working, and you're having time with your family and kids, you need to be having time with you and your mindset. So this is what I'm doing right now, even though I'm working and I've been on the appointments, I have a long clear to close. Congratulations to Charla and Dennis, amazing team to work with. Funding hopefully today or tomorrow for the Gonzalez family. Anyway, the point of the conversation is back to giving in United States. Europe, they don't have the culture of giving tips. All my friends, every time I went out for dinner or something, and I want to say, oh, so we're gonna give some tips. Everybody said, no, here we don't do that. You don't need to tip anybody. And I was like, I'm feeling bad. Like, why not? I just wanna give, that's my money, don't worry. Everybody was so worried about my money. Like, no, take the money. You don't need to spend 2, 3 euros, 5 euros to tip the guy. And I was like, okay, I understand that you could, but the few times I did it, everybody was like that. Thank you. I'm very sure if everybody changed the mindset over there in the culture about giving more, the economy over there is gonna get better, everybody's gonna be making more money, and everybody's gonna be spending more money, and then the economy is gonna be moving forward more. Because over there is a crisis. Everybody, even the people making good money, they're just talking about the economy, how bad it is. Hey, Marianne, that was awesome meeting you over there in Spain. I'm just talking about my trip. So those are kind of the little difference between Europe and America is the mindset about the money. Here we are living in a full abundance and we can just go and get it. If you are broke or you don't have any money, it's because it's your choice. Here in America, you can go and do it and get it. I understand in Europe, probably it's a little bit more complicated. But that is my point of view on the trip in America and Europe. And I'm back to normal. I'm happy to be back. I love what I do. Even though being on vacation is awesome, I was missing this. I was missing my kids. I was missing the environment. I was missing the people I'm surrounding myself. I was missing helping others to get the proof, to get the house, to get the appointment, to get the paperwork, that assignment of getting somebody approved to get the house. So I'm happy to be here and I'm happy to be on training exactly after the vacation because I can just put everything on full motion. And Relentless, the event where I am right now, is the whole thing combined because in the morning we have the workout at 5:30 in the morning, which is awesome. Today I was exhausted, I couldn't do the whole routine because during my vacation, I was walking an average of 15, 20 miles a day. Walk. I didn't rent any car. Everything was walking, bus, train, the plane, boat. So now I'm back to walking and running and doing the cardio and eating healthy. And I love that. So the point about being back to normal is because the training yourself, training your mindset, training your business or training yourself to work better on the business, it has to be something that you do like working out at the gym, like eating healthy, like reading a book, like taking a bath or taking a good sleep every night. It has to be something as a routine all the time. You need to be all the time, this muscle right here on your brain, getting better with that training. And that's the reason why I love the training right now. And I try to do a training every 3-4 months. Relentless, yesterday we have Mikey Garcia, the champion, boxing champion, 4 belts, 4 different divisions. He stayed with us during the night in the dinner and in the mixer, and we just talk. He was so humble, so super cool. He shared with us everything. Imagine spending 2-3 hours with a world champion, 4 different divisions, 4 belts, talking about anything and everything, asking anything you want. That is just a lifetime experience that I never have before. Just to let you know how big it was, and I cannot believe you guys are missing that. So I had that opportunity. Besides Mikey Garcia yesterday, we're on the stage, the couple Chris Hutter and Lori Hutter, amazing couple. They were talking things that was opening my mind. And that's something I'm gonna be giving as a message to my kids after finish this part of Relentless. It's just the mindset is so important that it is okay if you reject anybody's opinion or advice if those advice or opinion are not aligned with your vision, with your mindset. It's okay. You don't need to apologize. You don't need to say pretty much anything. Just thank you. I don't need that. Bye bye. Or you can be probably more nice, you know. What else I gonna say? Okay. Another thing is for my kids, Victoria, Sebastian. We have an amazing time at Disney. That was probably the best thing. That was better than the vacations. That was better than meeting Mickey Garcia. We have a blast. But the point is, yesterday on the training, they were talking about it is okay to disappoint people sometime if those people are not in the same mindset as yours. If you are looking for a different thing in your life, if that's making you happy, if you're becoming the better version of you every day, and when you're doing that, some people during the road get disappointed because they don't believe in you, because they don't believe in what you're looking for, or what you wanna do, or they just don't think the same way, it is okay if they get disappointed. Don't worry about it. You just stay happy. The happiness is up to you. Happiness is a choice. And that's it, guys. It's just great time. Let me tell you this. If you know anybody who's looking to do a refi and is asking you, do you think it's a good time to refi? Oh, yes. It is the best time to refi. And even better, I was just reading the news, and it looks like they want to drop the rate. Can you believe another cut on the rate? Because they think the economy is slowing. I was reading another thing on the news that car sales globally are down almost 10%. That might be a sign that yes, things are slowing. And that's a good thing for us if the rates go down. Like I say in the video before or the 2 weeks before, if the rates go down, you know what's gonna happen? We're gonna move forward because the economy is gonna be stimulated. And we can take advantage of that. If you have a high rate over, right now, if you are like over 4.5 or 4.75, you can probably drop the rate to 3.75. It's gonna be a good saving on your mortgage. You can probably remove the mortgage insurance, you already have 20% equity. If not, we will be there. All right, guys, that's it. It's time to go to the training. Love you, peace out. If you have questions, let me know. Please share. Please remember my Instagram account is Carlos Lopez Global. I'm here to help you, and I'm here to serve you, and I'm here to spend quality time and enjoy the life and do better and becoming better. Love you, peace out. Ozzy, take care, my man.